Hello, and thank you for joining us today. My name is Michael B. Judkins. I'm a community science collaborator for the Noise Project of Allentown, and I'm joined with my fellow CSEs to discuss the important question, where in Allentown is your safe space away from noise? So my safe space away from noise is on the south side of Allentown in Lehigh Park.
My name is Eric Pitardo, and I'm a CSE for Central Allentown. I like to listen to music in the library, Allentown Library. It's a public library, anybody can join, and I just go there to relax.
Hi, my name is Jay, and I live over in the west side of Allentown. My main safe space would be Fessler Park, actually. It's a really quiet park, and it's a lovely area, just get away.
Hello, my name is Siobhan, and I'm a CSC member of Allentown on the east side. And my safe space from the noise pollution in our city is actually my house, where I go in my room and seek refuge there. To bring this conversation back together, why are we here and why are we having this discussion? Because we want to let our viewers know, why is noise pollution important to us and why are we even speaking about it?
Yeah, I can definitely tell you from my perspective. And I think to answer the question, I think you have to ask yourself, what is noise pollution to you? I know to me, noise pollution was something I never really thought of before in the grand scheme of my life, my day-to-day activities. Offered to join this project earlier this year, it made me think about my own habits on what is noise in my life and what does that constitute? Is it just loud music? Is it traffic? Is it noisy neighbors? Is it the dog that never seems to stop barking at every car, every person that walks by in your neighborhood? So understand what is noise pollution. I think you have to sit down and identify what does noise mean to you and your family or your loved ones, and figure out how that affects your life.
Well, how I think about noise is, like, as a child, I lived in low-income houses, like moving the house everywhere, and I see my friends doing the same things, and it affects them. It's like a big issue for them.
I live over in the west side, like I said again, and we have townhouses, a lot of townhouses over there, and the walls are paper thin. And the way that I describe noise is, any sort of noise or any sort of, you know, sound that can disrupt you. You know, we have good noise, we have bad noise, but we're talking about the bad noise right now. And with those paper thin walls, you can hear everything that your neighbors are doing. If they're yelling at each other, you hear that. That is disruptive. That is noise to me. If the plane comes over your head, you really feel as though that plane's gonna fall into your backyard because it's that loud.
Wow.
So that's really what I find disruptive in my neighborhood, is just people living, you know what I mean? And, you know, we live life, but it's still, you know, it impedes on other people's noise, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
I never knew that noise had such a big effect in my life.
Yeah.
As you mentioned, it has come to realization of your habits and the things that you're doing that are really affecting you, but you're not knowing. And I joined this project knowing that I have a chance on making an impact in my city.
Wow.
And a kid that grows up in a low-income area doesn't get that and get to see the benefit of that opportunity or anything like that. So for me, I'm here for the sole purpose of figuring out, what are those bad habits? What are those noises that are actually affecting me? And how can I help in a way that I can help somebody that doesn't even know that maybe listening to the music louder than it's supposed to be listened to could affect your hearing as you get older? And yet, exactly, it keeps going up. And you don't understand because you're so used to that. And I think we're immune to the noise that we're surrounded.
Mm-hmm.
By
yeah.
And a lot of people, that's why I don't think people notice it as much, because we're so used to the traffic, the noise, people driving by with their music and stuff like that. That's the era that I'm growing up in, where noise is something that is common among us.
So I like how you ended that off with Siobhan. So if it's common to us, how do we educate our community on ways so we can reduce noise in our areas? Like, what is some of the things that we learned so far being involved in this project, that if you could say one thing to educate somebody that's watching this video or is going to be watching us do several videos over the next course of the year, what would be that one thing we want to tell them?
Spend time with yourself. Mm. For me, I just recently decided to take a break off of social media and really to cut away from the distractions, because I realized that I couldn't cure my mental thinking or my voice. And I decided to make the effort of spending more time with myself and away from these distractions. Whether it's just taking a break from social media, or whether it's just taking time to go to the park and just walk and just be around nature. Because we don't make time for ourselves. And I think that's what most people are missing out on, is making that effort to be alone with yourself, to learn more about who you are, and to just hear your thoughts. And I think that's what most people are kind of missing.
Yeah, I feel the same way. I mean, we all have lives out of this. We all have to go to work. We all have to go to school. We have kids. We have all sorts of responsibilities. And sometimes with all that clutter in your life, you don't get to have, you know, just the privilege of just sitting and being quiet and just, you know, being with yourself. So I agree with that. I just feel as though, like, we need to just take it easy. I know you got things to do, but just take it easy. Stop and smell the flowers, even if it's just 2 minutes. Think, you know, reflect upon yourself. Instead of maybe doing something that you would, you know, at your lunch break, maybe just go to the park. And I know that's an investment, but sometimes you need to
it's
invest
in yourself.
Yeah, you gotta invest in yourself.
Yeah.
Be, you know, just calm.
I agree.
Yeah.
All right. You just figure out the issues for it. Mm. And you let yourself know that you're loved. So let yourself know that you might be affecting others. Just keep that in your head and keep that in mind to actually help around the community.
Yeah, I think I have to go with all you guys, my fellow community science collaborators, but also with Eric's point, because I know I had to do that.
Yeah.
I had to do that when I got involved in this project. For somebody who loves music and into music and do all this stuff, that was my common. That was my common thing. You know, if I hear a great song, I'm listening to my Spotify, you know, that's my thing, and I'm rolling, you know, and I'm listening to my jam. But when I got involved with this, I honestly have to say, I had to question myself, and then I had to look at, why am I listening to music loud in this one area, but in this other area, I'm not listening to music loud? And that made me question my own thought processing on what noise pollution is to me. And I think that's one of the, for me, it's to act the one way I want to educate this community about noise pollution is, don't be afraid. Look at noise as something negative, but look at it as something to where you can benefit from reducing it to improve your lifestyle. So I don't know if you are in agreement with that. I think all of us have some really great things to say.
I mean, what you're saying is, like, to have that self-awareness of noise pollution and to see how it affects you as a human being, and it's not to completely, like, just get rid of the noise, you know, not to just, like, say, you know what, I had enough of society, I'm moving into the woods. That's not what you're trying to say, but to just, and what Eric said as well, to be more self-conscious about it when you go to your day-to-day life, and to just say, you know what, if I make this small adjustment, this may improve the quality of the way that I'm living.
Correct.
Yeah, and we're talking about your overall health here, too. It's like, not only is it good for the environment, you know, we have different animals that also get affected by the noise. Your ears get affected by the noise. The way your cognitive ability is affected by noise. All these sorts of things, your mood, your emotions, whether you have depression, whether you have emotional issues, can be affected by noise. So it's like, how much are you willing to give to benefit yourself, or how much are you willing to say, you know what, I do this, but maybe if I didn't do that, I'd be a little bit healthier. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's all about managing yourself.
Yeah.
And even then, like, it spreads through communities. Because some of the housing, like in our housing, cheap housing, they don't have really reinforced walls, so you could basically hear everything through it. It affects families, and it affects the whole community, because those children grew up in those noisy neighborhoods, and they lose hearing, they lose anything that they feel, and they always feel like something's over them and like something that is like, it's like very stressful for them when they grow up. And it's, it affects them. It affects the community as well. And I feel that if we could just figure out our like ideas and like put it in like conscious thought, maybe we can actually reduce it to, for the benefit of our community.
You want to find that solution where we can actually give back to the city of Allentown, benefit the lives of our community, to collaborate with Cornell on the research that they're doing, to do research on our own, because I'm sure that, for instance, you are no more conscious on how you go through your daily life.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure that you're taking notice to like how people react to certain noise, like you're starting to observe your environment and how noise plays a role in that environment. So each and every one of us, we have a role, a task, a hand to play and to be those gatekeepers, to find that solution that people are looking for. And maybe some people are not searching for it, but on the inside they are, and they just want that, that solidarity, that, that quietness or that peace of mind that they can just refer to their mental state, you know? And I think that's why we're here, is to figure out what is that solution? How can we better our city? How can we leave a mark or make an impact?
Yeah, I mean, everybody's having their stressful lives.
Mm-hmm.
Their, you know, downtown is getting built up. We have so many, we have workers on those streets like every day fixing these potholes.
Mm-hmm.
It's
fixing
stressful. All we want to do is just keep the peace, keep some sort of sanity in this really insane world right now.
Awesome. Well, you know, I don't know about you guys, but I feel inspired, motivated, and educated.
Yes.
For the last couple of minutes. But, you know, we're going to have a lot of great discussions and a lot of materials and educational stuff posted on our Facebook page. For that way you guys could follow us. And on this video, on down below, you'll be able to look at the link or attach it to the video of our Facebook page. For that way you can be involved in your area and find out what is the noise pollution. And I would like to thank my fellow science collaborators from coming out tonight and sitting down and having this coffee house conversation. I always love meeting up with you guys because this is a new experience for me. And when I walked into here, I said, you know what? I'm green. I don't care. I want to know, because I left myself open to that. So
yeah.
I appreciate every moment that we get to chat and talk, because I'm learning something new from each and every one of you. So I hope that you enjoyed yourselves tonight, and then hopefully to next time, and then
all right,
ciao.
Guys.
All right.
Ciao.
Yep.
Bye.
Bye.
Love you, Zan.